Now then YouTube, I am the Tough Man and welcome back to my Tottenham Simulator Manager mode, where we're at Uruguay now for the game against Brazil. And this is for World Cup qualifiers. We are currently qualifying for the World Cup. Whether or not we're going to go through, we don't quite know yet. Well, that looks like a good team to me. I think we can get straight on with it. I don't think there's anything that's made any difference. We're currently sitting in fourth in the World Cup qualifiers, but we're all on similar amount of points. So this is a big match against Brazil. And they won 2-0. Hulk and Neymar both scoring the goals there. So now we've dropped down, guys, to just qualifying. But this game against Chile is going to be a big one, I think. It would push us back up there. You can't see the form of these guys. Let's move Cavani. Let's move Cavani on the right, Hernandez in the middle, and Suarez on the left there. Let's see if that helps us out some. One nil, Pereira scoring for us, and that is a good result, guys. I think, if I'm right in my calculations, that puts us now qualified. I could be wrong there. 23, with 10 points, maybe not yet then. Maybe not yet, but I would think that we are.
Well, second place, Chelsea.
Back at Spurs now, game against Swansea. Casemiro. Mermich is actually in better form. So that's what I mean with De Bruyne. He just doesn't seem to stay on form at all. He just always seems... Hey, Hummels has gone up in form. Good stuff. I don't want to take him out. In fact, I want to get him in. That's the point. Let's put De Bruyne in. His morale's pretty bad. So is Lennon's, actually, and Hummels. We don't want them to go too far down, that's the problem. Yeah. Yeah, Narsing's not on form. Okay, so we'll deal with that. What happened to your subs anyway? Oh, what the fuck? Keeps doing that to me, it's annoying. Botello. No, it wasn't, it was Mermich all after, wasn't it? Mermich in there. Got no Gook. Let's get Walker back in. Still no Gook. Thing is, I don't want to take him out. That's just in case, guys. It's just in case. Okay, let's get back on with it. Away from home, Swansea. With the in-form team. Spurs. 1-0, Jovetic scoring the goal. The only goal in this game. Suspension is over with Casemiro. And the Champions League, here we are, guys. This is the reason why I'm continuing with this. So, I've been in pretty good form lately and I'm feeling good, so you're not going to bench me for the next game. Well, we'll soon find out. The energy is looking pretty low on the two guys at the front there, and Aggie is slipping in form slightly. Yao Vilna is, well, he should have more energy. Yes, he has got more energy. So that's good. Uh, Yeah, we'll leave Lennon in there. De Bruyne's gone up in form, actually, which is great news. Hummels, nice to have him back. Bruma's looking pretty good as well. And that looks a pretty good team there. I'm hoping the energy will carry us through this game against Wolfsburg. So let's find out. Champions League, the whole reason why, guys, I'm doing this entire playthrough is to win the Champions League, simulated-wise. Are you shitting me? I don't get it. I just do not get it. Away from home, a loss of 2-0. Now we've got Manchester United in the FA Cup. That is going to be a, you know, fuck up, that is. I'm just going to swap it out for all my shit players.
Let's look ahead to the next round of fixtures of the FA Cup. And in the tie of the round, Tottenham Hotspur entertain Manchester United.
It's not tie of the round because I'm fucking
Everton
it up.
Host Manchester City. Wigan Athletic entertain Cardiff City. Also, Reading host Leighton Orient.
Okay. De Leon's in. Nathaniel Klein is in. Vertonghen's in. Kabul's in. Bay's in. Narsing's not in. Casemiro's not in. So I want to get Botello in there. Mermic. Morelles. Vilner. Botello. Okay. That's the team that's going to be taking Manchester United on. Come on. You're thinking of playing Morelles instead of me, boss? Yes, I am. Because I don't want to be in the fucking cup. Because FIFA can't arrange days properly. Oh my god. This is a joke. This is an absolute fucking joke. I put my first team out against somebody like Stoke and I lose like fucking 2-0 or something. I put my shittest team out against Manchester United and I end up with a 1-1 fucking draw. Now I've got another game to fucking play. Brilliant.
Manchester United.
Fucking brilliant.
Wigan Athletic 2, Cardiff City 1.
It's doing my tits in. And it seems to always happen as well. You always get a replay. So I'll get two games in 2 days in a minute. You fucking watch. It's a joke. It's an absolute fucking joke. I knew I should have just put the fucking team out of goalkeepers. Oh, got two games in 3 days now. Just beat me for fuck's sake. I even made it easy on you. Oh my fucking lord, look at this bullshit.
Let's look ahead to the next round of fixtures of the FA Cup.
Bad enough. I've had enough of FIFA's bullshit. See, that's the Saturday. Then I'm going to have a game on the Wednesday as well. Or the Tuesday even, possibly. For the Champions League. Alright, Man United versus Spurs. Come on now, knock us out, for fuck's sake. Eventually. E-fucking-ventually. Sandro's picked up a suspension. Victor Soriano. Still not ready yet, but it's still going alright. Vertonghen faces the axe. Yeah, it's the fucking Tuesday. Wouldn't it? Would be. Fucking would be, wouldn't it? Not a fucking Wednesday, but it would happen to be the Tuesday. Alright, so we've got energy here, we've got the form. Oh, fuck's sake. Swap them two around. Narsingh's best one out of them. De Bruyne, best one out of them. Gareth Bale. Yeah, okay. And they're just looking pretty low on Hummels, but what can you do? Simulate match against Chelsea. I'll put a shit team out against Sunderland, and then I've got my team back again for the one against Wolfsburg. 3-0. Robinson getting an injury as well. Lovely. Is it a big one? Please don't tell me it's a big one. 3 months. He's broke his collarbone. Lovely stuff.
The Barclays Premier.
Joy. Norwich. Fucking joy.
Arsenal 1.
Sunderland.
Tottenham Hotspur 3. Chelsea.
I've got Uruguay to think about as well. You're probably not going to see whether or not I'm going to get qualified. Because if I lose against Wolfsburg or I don't go through in the Champions League, that's the end of this playthrough, guys. I'm serious about that. I'm getting tired of this bullshit.
Third and falling are Chelsea with 60 points.
Doesn't matter what team I put out, whether it's high on form, low on form, fucking big on overall, low on overall, you just can't seem to generate anything.
Behind on goal difference. In 6th, Manchester United with 46 points.
De Leon.
7th, Bolton Wanderers.
Daniel Klein.
43 points.
Vertonghen.
Newcastle United.
Kabul.
43 points. But only behind on
goal difference. It's going to have to be in Bay anyway.
On the table, Swansea City with 5 points. And then reading up the table, 2nd bottom,
Aaron Lennon.
Southampton with 16 points.
Mermich.
Bottom, Wigan Athletic with 19
Patello.
Points. Fourth bottom, Queen's Rangers with 21 points.
Vilna.
Fifth bottom, Stoke City with Botello. 21 points.
Right, okay. That's the squad that's going to be facing off against Sunderland. You just can't seem to gauge it. This is what I mean. You can't seem to gauge what type of... Look! What the fuck is this? That's my worst team. Low on form. Shit. And I still beat Sunderland. Yet earlier on in the season, I had my best team out with great form and I fucking lost. And this is away from home. You can't seem to gauge it. The simulation on this game is a bag of shit. It's the worst simulation I ever fucking come across. It really is. You can't gauge it. And that's what annoys me.
1-2. Cardiff City.
Nothing seems to work. United. No system seems to have a constant.
Let's look ahead to the next.
I know that football can be random sometimes. You do end up with weird results, right? But this is all the fucking time.
Entertain Sevilla.
It just doesn't make sense. Hugo Lloris, Kyle Walker, Mats Hummels. Bruma. It's going to have to be Mbaye. Narsing. De Bruyne. Casemiro. Bale. Jovetic. And not Vilna. Where are you? Aggie. Oi. And that's it, guys. I could see this video ending right after this game, to be honest. But we'll see. It's a big match, so I'm going to let it play. If we win 3-0, we're through. If we win 2-0, it goes down to extra time and what have you. If we lose at all, or if Wolfsburg score at all, then, it's looking grim. But 1-0 so far, and B, now in the second half, 2-0 Spurs. Wolfsburg. Narsingh's got an injury. We're up to 3-0 Spurs. If Wolfsburg score, it goes on away goals and they are through. It's hanging on. It is hanging on by its fucking short and curlies, is this playthrough. 3-0, which means we do go through to the next round in the Champions League. Narsingh's out for 7 days with a hyperextended knee.
Champions.
And we've managed to catch up Chelsea to Arsenal, who are also having a hard time of it. We're now 3 points behind Arsenal. Fucking hell. It is hanging on by its short and curlies. Is this playthrough, guys. Today is the last day to submit the final list of players. We can do that. Easy enough. Just by pressing start. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Let's get a little bit further on, guys. Hopefully, if it will pick its ass up in gear. Oh, we've got internationals. Okay, international time. So, let's go to the calendar and see who we've got in the next round of the Champions League. How do we not find out yet? No, it's obvious that we don't find out who we've got yet in the Champions League. I'll let it play on just that little bit longer, I want to see. I may even do the games against Paraguay and whoever the other one is. Champions Cup, there it is, right. Does it show us in the
quarter final of the Champions Cup?
Champions League.
Inter
Chelsea, wonderful.
Tottenham Hotspur face Chelsea.
Wonderful. We've got Chelsea in the quarters of the Champions League. Wow. That's going to be interesting, sinners. Look at where we are in the table. We're second and third, respectively, on exactly the same points. We, head-to-head wise, we are above them. We've managed to beat them a few times. So, interesting what this is going to be. We should have the squad exactly as we want it to be honest. Don't think it's changed some. Nah, that's exactly how we want it. Simulate the match against Paraguay. World Cup qualifier right here. And I think this is the one, if we win, we're through. 3-1! Cortes, Cavani and Suarez. And you can see there, 26. We're still 10 points ahead. I don't quite know how many games are left, though. Boss, I can't lie. I was worried about that you had plans to replace me. I know now that it was all media speculation. Yeah, it was. Why are you talking to me when you're meant to be playing? Right, so what does that do to us? 13, how many teams is there? There's 5, there's 10 teams, that's 9, 18 games. There's 5 games left and we're only 10 points ahead. So, okay. This wouldn't harm to win this match. 2-0, Pereira and Suarez. Cortes getting injured again. He always seems to get injured when on international duties. So, we've got 4 games left. And it wouldn't allow me to see that quick enough. We've got 4 games left and we have qualified. Pretty much we have qualified for the World Cup, and that's what I wanted to do for Uruguay, to just qualify.
So what comes next?
And we've done that. So I map it.
The league leaders, Arsenal, visit 16th place Stoke.
Oh,
well, second place, Tottenham Hotspur.
Never mind. Well, I think that's that. We'll call it there, guys. We're going to call the episode there. I'm going to get these on the computer and what have you. But next video, guys, may even be the last. You never know. Again, one against Champions League in the quarterfinals, and from there we should, in the next set of videos, either end the series on a low. I'll end the series on a high, but we'll soon find out. So until then, guys, I have been the Toff Man as always. Stay safe.